गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, वेलकम बैक टू द सेशन 2021 एंड 2022। सिंस बिकॉज ऑफ कोविड 19 दिस ईयर ऑल्सो वी कुड नॉट मीट वन ऑन वन, सो माई नेम इज निकिता प्रधान एंड आई विल बी टेकिंग योर बायोलॉजी। ओके, आई होप एवरी वन ऑफ यू हैव योर बायो बुक। सो योर बायो बुक दिस फॉर दिस सेशन इज इनोवेटिव बायोलॉजी बाय गुड लक पब्लिशर। Now first let us go through the contents of the book, okay? So if you go through the contents of the book, your content is divided into 6 units. Unit 1 is your transport of food and minerals in plants. Unit 2 is reproduction in plants and animals. Unit 3 is ecosystem. Unit 4 is human body, endocrine, circulatory and nervous system. And unit 5 is health and hygiene. And unit 6 is food production, and total you have 10 chapters for this session. Okay, now yet we do not know the method, the scheme of examination. Okay, so after the scheme of examination is known, then I will be giving you the syllabus accordingly. Okay, so today's class I'll start with the first unit itself, that is unit 1. The name of the chapter is your transport of food and minerals in plants. Okay, so the name of the chapter is transport of food and minerals in plants. Okay, like all the higher organisms, okay, plants also have a transportation system. Now, in case of plants, the transportation system mainly has two purposes. Number one is to transport the absorbed water. Which part of the plant absorbs water? Root. Okay, so root absorbs the water from the soil and from roots to the transportation to the different parts of a plant. And another is transportation of the food. Where is food prepared in plants? In leaves. So from leaves to different parts of the plant, these are the two main function of transportation system in plants. But unlike animals, plants, they do not have a complex system like animals. Blood, they do not have proper blood circulatory system or lymphatic system for the circulation of the food or the nutrients. Okay, then what do plants have for the transportation of food and minerals to different parts of our what do they have? So plants, they have two important complex permanent tissues, also referred to as, the name of those complex permanent tissues are xylem and phloem. So these are the complex permanent tissues which helps in transportation in case of plants. Okay, now if you go through the role of xylem and phloem, the main role of the xylem is for the transportation of water. Okay, and the role of the phloem is for the translocation of food. So they have their own function to perform. Xylem helps in transportation of water, okay, or conduction of water to different parts of the plant from the root, and phloem helps in translocation of food which is prepared in the leaves to different parts of the plant. Is that clear? Okay, so plants, they do not have a complex system like other animals for the transportation. They simply use these two complex permanent tissues for carrying out the transportation purpose. Okay, that is for transportation of food, water and minerals. So next, we will be discussing in detail about the structural components of xylem and then about the phloem. Now let us discuss about the structural components of xylem. So we all know the function of xylem, right? It helps in conduction of water. So now if you go through the structural components of xylem, xylem is made up of trachytes, vessel, jhilum parenchyma and jhilum fiber. Now out of these four, tracheid is also made up of dead cells, vessel is also made up of dead cells and jhilum fiber is also made out of dead cell. Only your jhilum parenchyma is made out of living cell. Okay. Now if you go through the structure of what and this tracheids, vessel and jhilum parenchyma, these three are the conducting elements. That means these are the ones which help in conduction of water. Okay, jhilum fiber are just to provide a stiffness or strength to the jhilum. Other three, it helps as it acts as a conducting element. That means helps in conduction of water. Now, if you go through the structure of a tracheid, you can see this is how the tracheids look like. It is long, narrow, and then tapered. You can see it is tapered at both the end. Okay, and the cell wall of this tracheid is very thick and is made out of lignin. Okay, now, and next if you come to vessel element, now if you look at the vessel element as compared to tracheid, they are wider and shorter. Okay, now if you look at the end of the vessel element, it has a perforation plate. Perforation plate, that means a plate with a hole in it for the easy conduction of water and minerals. Okay, and your jhilum parenchyma, it helps in storage of food. Other than that, it also helps in conduction of water. And then you have jhilum fibers, they are connected with your tracheids and vessels. Okay, and then they are made up of sclerenchyma cells. We all know that sclerenchyma are the dead cells, right? So, and provides, just like sclerenchyma cells, what is its function? To provide a stiffness or rigidity to certain part. Similarly, your jhilum fibers does the same to the jhilum. Okay, so that's all you have to know about the jhilum. Next, we'll be discussing about the another transporting element of a plant, that is phloem. So the next vascular element or the tissue which helps in transportation or in case of plant is your phloem. So what is the role of a phloem? It helps in transportation of food, maybe in the form of sugar, organic material or any minerals that altogether in the form of plant sap. Okay, it is transported by the phloem. So altogether, let's name it as a food. Okay, so your structural components of phloem are living cell, because most of its components are made up of living cells. Okay, so phloem is made up of, the structural components of phloem are your sieve tube, companion cell, then you have phloem parenchyma and phloem fiber. Now out of these four, this is living, companion cell is living, phloem parenchyma is living. Only phloem fiber is made up of dead cell, and its purpose is to provide a rigidity or mechanical strength to the phloem. Okay, now given alongside is the structure of a phloem. So the main conducting element of a phloem is this tube. Which has a perforated plate at its end, also referred to as a sieve plate. Okay, now one of the feature of this sieve tube is, this sieve tube, they do not have nucleus, but even though they are living, right, and they do not have other cell organelles also, more in number. Why? So that food can easily pass through this sieve tube, so that these cell organelles do not form a hurdle for the transportation of the food. So the strength for transportation of the food is provided by the companion cell, which lies alongside the sieve tube. Okay, alongside you have a companion cell which provides a strength or gives a energy to the sieve tube for the transportation or translocation of the food. Okay, now it also helps in transporting the sugars from the neighboring cell, your companion cell. Okay, now another element of phloem is your phloem parenchyma. The function of this phloem parenchyma is to store the food for later purposes. Okay, and you have phloem fiber, which provides a strength, a mechanical strength to the phloem. Okay, so here you can see that the main conducting elements translocating elements or translocation of the food, which plays a main role in translocation of the food, are your sieve tube and your companion cell. Is that clear? So we got to know about the transportation system in case of plant, right? The two main tissues which helps in transportation of the water, minerals and food are your xylem and phloem. We went through the structural detail of xylem and phloem. I hope this video will help you to differentiate between xylem and phloem. Okay, so this is the main motive, that you should be able to differentiate between what is xylem and what is phloem, maybe based on its function or based upon its structure. Okay, for today's class, that's all. You go through this video, this time you all have a more role to play, because you have to go through the video, you have to go through your book also for the proper understanding or clear understanding. Just looking at the video will not help you. You have to go through the book or after watching the videos for better understanding of the topic. Okay, even then, if there is any problem regarding any topic that I am delivering, you all have our WhatsApp number. You can always contact in that particular number. Okay, so that's all for today's class. Next day we'll carry on with the topic from this particular chapter itself. Okay, thank you.